is the all-new 2019 Volvo V60. And of course, V stands for van, which in English means wagon. In Canada, you can choose between the Momentum and Inscription trim levels. You can get a 250 horsepower T5 Momentum front-wheel drive for $44,900. Or you can upgrade that to a 316 horsepower T6 all-wheel drive for Canadian $48,900. Or you can buy the top of the line Inscription, just like this one, for $55,400. Actually, our test model is equipped with all the bells and whistles, and it's about $65,000, which is a lot. So the best value for money here is get a Momentum with a T6 all-wheel drive and pick everything you want. And you know what? That's gonna work out to about $55,000, which is very reasonable. No matter which one you pick though, you'll be getting a really sexy looking wagon that will certainly make people humble down and turn their heads to look at it. Inside, it's equally attractive with top-notch materials used, very classy combination of materials, and overall the design is very nice. Fit and finish is excellent, and if you pick the Momentum, you can also opt for this cloth material for the seats for about $400, which actually looks fantastic, and it really feels really good too. We actually met the designer for this, and this is actually considered an upgrade. It's really good. The seats in the Inscription model are almost identical to the ones in the R-Design S60, and they are very good. They support the body really well, and they're very comfortable, and they are better than the ones in the Momentum. The infotainment system feels a bit better done this time. It responds really quickly and works wonderfully with both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. However, there's no cable cutout to avoid crushing your cables under the armrest, where the USB port lives. The driving position is also really good. The seat is very adjustable, so no matter what body type you are, you will get comfortable, and visibility is great. The massive sunroof makes the cabin feel very airy, and the kids in the back will love it. Roominess in the back seat is very generous. Legroom and headroom are very good. Only the center tunnel is a bit big and might bother the third person in the middle. The trunk is also massive. You get 530 liters if you stop loading at the window height, but much more if you keep going. You also get very helpful things like hooks and straps, which makes life so much easier. The 2.0-liter four-cylinder that lives under the hood is twin-charged, which means it has both a supercharger and a turbocharger, helping it make 316 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of torque. Made it to a pretty good 8-speed automatic, it can hit 100 kilometers an hour in just under 6 seconds. And in general, performance is really good. It packs a really good low-end punch, and it pulls strong all the way up to the red line. But the one thing that's kind of shocking is the absence of paddle shifters. I mean, come on! And here's another very weird thing. You know how the gas pedal has a little kick-down button right behind it, so if you press it completely, you feel that little click, and that means basically just downshift and go as quickly as you can. The problem is when you do that in this car, it then ignores the manual shift inputs, and in the S60 R-Design with the paddle shifters, it's the same thing. I mean, you do a kick-down, but then you decide, okay, I want to upshift, but the car will ignore you, and I will demonstrate this right now. So I'm in manual mode, first gear, kick down. Second, third. No. I think that's a bug. I don't think they intended to do that. Fuel economy isn't that bad, but isn't that great either. On average, we use about 11.2 liters per 100 kilometers. The best part is that surprisingly, they gave it a really cool exhaust note. I mean, just listen to this growly thing. Nobody said a wagon needs to be boring, right? And the fun continues once you hit twisty roads. The double wishbone front suspension makes turn-in sharp, and the steering feels quite good too. A little bit light, but nevertheless good. It's easy to point and shoot, and the car feels very responsive. At the rear, to maximize loading capacity, they used leaf springs. No, don't think it's a solid axle kind of leaf spring thing. It's still a multi-link rear independent suspension, but it has a leaf spring instead of coil springs, and you know what? It actually works really well. The sporty handling and high grip limits don't exactly come by compromising ride comfort. They've tuned the suspension really nicely, and the V60 rides very well. Most bumps and potholes are filtered out pretty well, but there is a little bit more road noise than I'd like. It's very nice to drive and, once again, as safe as possible, as Volvo is second to none in that category. There's a 3-speed mechanism for lowering the windows, and actually, it makes a little ooh sound, which is really addictive. Check this out. Let's do that one more time. I've been doing that all week. So overall score is 8.8 out of 10. Just because those paddle shifters are missing, and because you need to pay extra for rear heated seats and the heated steering wheel, no matter which trim level you pick.